exciting because of, you know, working with, Russ and I just worked together and have done for, you know, monogamously for 20 years. And now suddenly we're working with people like Phelan and Robert, and they have a completely different sensibility, completely different experience, different kind of things that they do. And that makes it exciting.
Into the bedroom. Into the bedroom. It's all arranged. Rickenbacker is in the country for the season. Rupert's bringing him to Glyndebourne tomorrow. My job is to have Hardcastle at Glyndebourne in position when they swing by informally for a chat.
What's this?
Boom!
Jumped out of his skin. Over there, Clive.
We've got a crisis, Clive.
The challenge is to try and get the audience engaged in those other characters. I'm hoping that maybe when the audience don't just see one character on stage running around, then they might see several.
Mrs. Hardcastle, Gillian, can I tempt you?
Oh, Alex, it's such a quintessentially English event, isn't it?
Shut up, isn't it about time you went to the loo? No, don't hold my hand, Penny, you're supposed to be cooperating. No, Mrs. H is giving us sentimental looks now. It's not sweet, Mrs. Hardcastle. She's doing it on purpose to annoy me. Oh, Penny just gave me a kiss. She knows I hate public displays of affection.
I don't see them odd enough as cartoons, really, when I'm doing it. I have to react off them. And I couldn't react off them if they were just drawings.
No, Penny, I was going to say you. I was.
Oh, aren't I lucky? Oh, Penny, is that for me?
Oh. I'm more or less the same age as Alex now, and he's sort of coming perhaps to the end of his life in the city. Well, he's regarded as a dinosaur, and that's one of the points that's made. I mean, of course, no, he's good at his job, and he's stuck in there.
And this is where he says, good man, Alex, you've still got your edge. I think this is going to be okay. Oh, he still doesn't get it. I'm going to have to deal with this.